Hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Cozy Grove, and I'm gonna have to get rid of some of all this, because I don't even have room to carry everything that we're moving around right now, but all this stuff I kinda wanted to sell, so let's see what we're gonna make for it. So 20 common lock cabin fences and things, yep, there we go. So all this should be what we need: common lock cabin delights. Yes, so that makes 4,100 old coins. Awesome. Yep, and there's no lamps or anything here, so that's good. Sell all. Very nice. Okay. And then, let's go back over here. Yeah, ran out of space, so I couldn't actually carry all of this. Let's pick you all up. So there we go. Yep. And let's pick up, see if we can get them all here. Pick up. How much room do I have? I still have like 5 slots left. Pick up, and there we go. Come on. Yes. And you. And then we have you, and I do see one more right there in the back, if I have room for it. Nice. Okay, so I think that was all of those. Yep, so we're completely full. Okay, so they all dislike rustic, if I remember correctly. They like potted flower plants, lamp, and cozy decor. But if you put them all next to each other, I don't think you actually need any kind of decor for them, because if you have enough of them around each other and no rustic decor, they should actually buff each other, right? But they do like, I think they all like rustic decor or cozy decor and dislike rustic. There we go. And they have no issues with common or uncommon or anything like that. Nope. Okay, so they all agree on that. Then we have this little birdie here that likes potted flower plants. So of course that's kind of ideal, putting it near them. Or we can put them near the lamp and natural decor. Okay, but it dislikes uncommon, but I'm kind of keeping all the uncommon and rare and stuff out of this area. Then we have the other demon deer, likes rare, lamp, and cozy decor. Eventually, I would like to get more deers. So, we might have to kind of rearrange some stuff at some point, but this makes me think that it might be handy to kind of have the cozy decor in the middle, and then place the deer on one side, and then later when we get more deers, we can put some on the other side or something like that, right? That could be the deal. So, yep. Okay. But I am kind of pondering where I want all these flowers to be. So I'm not quite sure if we need, well, some of this we are gonna need for the trees, but the trees might also just buff each other, because they like fruit trees, lamp, but they also like natural decor. But maybe they can buff each other enough that we don't actually really need them. They're kind of tall though, so I would like to have them over here. The only one is really the deer, because you like potted flower plants, so all these should easily buff you. But you, we're gonna need some cozy decor for you, so let's see what we have. When it comes to cozy decor, you're spooky, common, plant, antique, natural decor. There's some of this that I would like to keep just because I think it's pretty, but like we have some of this wicker stuff is so big. Okay, this is the gate, common wicker ornament. This will be the highlight. I think this is the really big one. Common wicker end table, that should be a tiny one, so that might work. Let's see, then we have a large potted plant to decorate your campsite, cozy. That might be a good choice. Natural decor, and then of course we have the flowering bush for the beach. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I think we're gonna try and make, what is it you don't like? You don't like rustic decor. So I have to make sure, if I kind of follow the line here, right? Let's see. Let's try and grab. I just want to make sure I don't debuff any of them. So let's just pick up one little piece here. Okay, let's put you there. And then we're going to take this. And then we're going to go over here. Somewhere around here is where we're going to end up having more cozy decor. It might be a little closer over here, but just to make sure, right? So you are going to go... That was this one. Rustic decor place here. Aha. Yep, so that was that little one, right? And then we have to get far enough away that the flowers won't get impacted. We also have this tree here I would kind of like to try and avoid so that I can actually see if they have flowered, because that's sometimes really hard to see over here, right? These trees are kind of in the way a little bit, and I would like these trees to be a little bit up in the back because then they don't block everything else. So I think this is where we're gonna go with some of our flowers, right? So we're gonna place you right here. It's right on the edge. Might be a little too... Let's pick you up. Just back up a little bit. So around here somewhere. Okay. Place. Yeah, that would work. Right? And then try and get them pretty close together, because that way you can always use the next, you know, pick next or something, or switch to next to access it when you can't, when you have trouble accessing things, if I could speak. So place here. There we go. You can see now they are busy buffing each other, which is exactly what I wanted. There we go. Let's try and place something else. Place here. Very nice. Okay, so I love that they have different pots actually. Oh, that is pretty cool. Place here. Yep. Okay, so that was one more of those. See, now I'm starting to get a little bit particular here. Okay, why can I not pick next on you? I can select next on this one, but okay, pick up. Because I didn't want two blue pots right next to each other. So let's see what this one has. Place here. Yeah. Oh, that's better. That's better. Okay, and then go in the back here somewhere and place here. That was that little blue pot. Yep. Mm-hmm. And let's see what you have. That was a little wooden pot that we haven't seen before, so that was nice. And then let's place this one. And we're still, so we can see it for this, so that's nice. We can barely see them for each other, but it doesn't really matter that much. Right now it's just really hard to see. I think one can fit in here somewhere. Place. There we go. Yep. This is getting very cramped, but it is okay. They are lovely. It's really hard to avoid, but this way they all kind of buff each other. We could probably move them further away from each other, but then the problem is if you, I'm trying to hit this and I can't hit, or I'm trying to hit one of these over here, for instance, if I move these up a little bit and try and hit this, then I end up, you know, marking one over here, and then they're too far away from the set for that select next option, right? So that's why I want them this close to each other, because that seems to be the easiest one, or easiest way to handle it. There we go, look at that. So now they are all fully buffed and we don't actually need any other decor for them. So that's cool. Potted puppy. Okay, we still have one there. This one had to go on a beach, yes. So we're just gonna go down here. And there we go, and I have to start writing down later. as I see them flowering, what they actually are, so I can have a list of which ones I already have, right? There we go. Okay, so now we have our walnut trees. They all like lamps and cozy decor. Okay, so they would like the same as our deer, which of course I put in here somewhere. Yep, so you go up there. Okay. And what else do we have? Then we have our adult forest. You like the potted flower plants. I'm kind of thinking we're going to put you over here somewhere. You can kind of just bounce around by yourself. Maybe we'll put you kind of over here a little bit. Do you have a problem with rustic decor? No, you're just this like common. Aha. So I think if I place you here, you're kind of going to be behind a tree, but it's going to be moving around, so it shouldn't be a big deal. Otherwise, we can rearrange it. But there we go. That should be fine. Right? And then... yes, adult forest bird, you have tree hats, so that should be fine. Now you are sorted out. And then... we needed something cozy, right? So all of this was the natural stuff and spooky stuff. So you are common, or you are cozy. You are cozy, but I don't think I really want to keep that gate. Then we have the little end table. That would be really handy. You are natural. You are natural. This large potted plant. Yes, I think we like that. Okay. Cool. So now we have to get all that in, but I think we're going to grab these as well, get them out of the way. Here we go. If I can get it. You all like legendary epic fruit tree. Yes, lamp and natural decor, but I'm kind of thinking they can all buff each other. Just have to check there's no like dislikes. Only the bustling. That's the only thing they don't like, it seems. So that's cool. Which kind of makes sense, because it's something like very steampunky, usually the bustling decor. So let's grab you. Like the bustling decor is something like this one over here, if I remember correctly. Well, that's not necessarily steampunky, but it is something like, I guess, very mechanical, electrical, something like that, right? So it's anti-natural, I guess. And then we have you. You like the fruit trees, so that's probably where you want you. Haha! Look at that! But just look at how much less messy it is now. Ooh! Okay, so... now the thing is to try and get in some of the fruit trees that were kind of some big ones. So let's see. You are a small one. Oh, come on. Pick up. Okay, so you are kind of a small one, right? Let's try and place you. You are a small one as well. Pick up. Okay, let's put you there. And then... oh, no. Well, didn't have to put you there. Let's see what you are. Place here. Okay, you are one of the bigger ones. So that is handy. Let's try and get you kind of right in the corner, I think. Place. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to try and get another one in here. So these three we have to kind of check. There we go. Let's try and place you. Yes, that's another big one. See, now we can easily access both of them, right? So I think that would work nicely. I'm probably going to want more fruit trees as we progress. But there we go. That's a beginning. And they are nicely buffing each other. So in the beginning, you need a lot of decor because you don't have that many trees and birds and all this. But once you... and flowers, or especially trees and flowers. But then as you progress, they can actually just buff each other. Okay, so it looks like we only have small ones left. So I think we're going to put all of those kind of in the front here, right? So you are going to go right here. I know it's kind of getting a little cramped, but... there we go. I'm going to want more. And there we go. I just have to be able to see. I can click this. I can click that. Very nice. Let's place you right here. And then we can try and get some big ones in later when we get some either from a quest or buy them. Or in a new season, there's probably going to be other trees. We have to remember right now is spring. So once we enter summer, then we'll probably get some new trees, and same for all for fall and things. And then we might actually have to rearrange some things to get it all to fit. But hopefully the fruit trees from the other seasons will also like fruit trees, for instance, so we can place them together, and the nut trees will like the other nut trees potentially. Okay, so that was these guys, and then of course we had this little one that liked the fruit trees. So for now we're going to place you right over here. That should be easily accessible. So there we go. Nice. You can bounce around there by yourself. Look at that. Yep. And then we need this. So we have some walnut trees, which will easily block something so we can't see anything, right? Light cozy decor. So I think this was the big one, right? No, that's a small one. So that's good. Yes. That's not going to block much. Which one is the big one? It's probably this one. Common Vigor Ornament, yes. So I really like the look of this, but it is pretty big, and it will easily block some stuff. But the deer is fairly big, and we could just place some of the walnut trees behind it, because we should easily be able to access them. And then we could have a deer over here and a deer over here, for instance, to kind of try and keep them away from each other, since they don't like each other, right? But I'm thinking you could easily have some trees in the back here, but no problems. And then we can leave a little room there for more cozy decor, potentially. So let's try and put... I don't remember if these were all big, but... No, this was a small one. I had a feeling. But that would be okay. We can still see you. So, yep. And then let's try and put one around here. Nice. Yes, that was a big one. And that way it doesn't block anything here, at least not yet. Why can I not see you? Don't be all shy on me like this. There we go. Okay. Just need a little hug. Okay. And then let's see if we can put one here. Might block this, but let's see how it goes. Right, so place. Can we still see the tree behind you? Yes. There we go. Now we can access you, can access you, can access you. We can access these. Yep, and still the bird. Yeah. That would all work, right? Okay, and then we might see if we get another little tree, then we can put it here. And do they all have, like... No, definitely need more cozy decor. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, good thing I'm gonna put some of that here. So we had the cute end table. Then we had the common, this one. We also have the gate, but... Not quite sure. Well, it looks pretty, but I'm kind of thinking maybe we can put it here in the back, but it's not going to buff the deer then. But then it's kind of out of the way and it doesn't block anything. So until we get something better or smaller, we can put it here. There we go. And it's kind of away, right? Okay, and then we're going to go right here and we're going to put you there. Okay, we're getting there. And then we have the... Okay, you know what? Let's actually pick you up and put you kind of over here so we more easily could see that it's there. Okay, so we're going to put you there, and then we're going to put... Oh, this is such a balancing act, but let's put you in right there. Okay, so they're not quite there yet. So why is that? Because I'm pretty sure we had three before, so there's something. It might be because we had a lamp near them. I think we had a lamp. So we have a bioluminescent mushroom, natural decor, common themed lamp. We have a common gothic lamp, which I actually kind of like the look of. That was this one. But not sure I really want it here, but I definitely want to hang on to it, also just because it's a lamp, and lamps are hard to come by. Then we had the little flower pool. That doesn't take up much room. Did these guys like the natural stuff? I think we need a lamp for them. Yeah, lamp or cozy decor. But I do kind of like this little pool, actually. Where were you? So let's just place you over here for now. That will also buff these guys, so... Just because it looks kind of cute. And then we had common bamboo, small potted plant, natural decor. Which one was you? Alright, that's that tiny little one. That is probably good to hang on to because it should be easy to fit in somewhere. What do these look like? The bamboo, I never actually got them placed. Oh, they look like that. We can craft these. We can craft these, so I think we're just gonna sell them. So let's sell you, then we still have the deer, but I have to figure out these trees. Duration, natural decor, common plant, antique. And that's a unique find. I also really like this one. So I think we're gonna hang on to you. We could also put that up here, but right now we don't really need it, so Come on, bamboo, small potted. Yes, wanted to keep you. And then what do you look like? Oh, that's a little mushroom. Yes. Yes, yes. Okay, so we are gonna put you over here. Maybe right here. It's gonna be a little hidden, but I'm kind of thinking I want it to affect this, and I want to maybe fit, well, I don't think we want to fit another tree in here. Oh, maybe if we can get a smaller one, because the big ones will block this, right? So, yep, there's a lot of considerations going into this, but there we go. Look at that. Now they are all at tree, and the lamp, of course, pretty much impacts everything here, so that's cool. Wow, look at this. Okay, so common garlic lamp, I kind of want to hang on to you. And then we have our deer, which just likes a cozy decor, and lamps. If I place you up here, we could place it over here, but I want to see if there's enough here. I don't think there's enough here if we do it. Place you here. Kind of block the bird a little bit though. But you do have tree hearts. Mm-hmm. So if I bring you down a little bit, I place you here. No, it's gonna be too far away, and then there's gonna be times where it's not gonna have its buff. So I think we're gonna put you close to this as we absolutely can, because then you can't wander too far away. Yep, there we go. Nice. Yes, you have three hats now, and then you're kind of gonna wander around a little bit here. Okay, that might look a little bit silly because you're walking around in the middle of stuff, so yep. So we got just gonna bring you back a little bit here and see if that still gives you the three hats. Yes, and then we'll see if it wanders too far away or not. But there we go. Wow, look at how empty this place looks now. Yeah, and we still have lots of room for more birds. We have, or more animals in general. We have room for more flowers. We have room for more fruit trees. Oh yeah, this is good. I think this is good. Okay, so finally, that took a long time, like almost an hour, to get all that sorted, but we got it. So now let's grab our tools again, then we can place this when we get down to the beach later. And these I wanted to sell. This was the natural decor I wanted to keep. Your natural decor I want to keep. And then we have this. It's spooky decor, common gothic, but we can use it for now at least. We can always choose to change that, but we could use it. This is also a common steampunk lamp. We can use it to try and help our little path leading over so that we can keep things lit up, which I don't really feel like we need that much, but we might reach a point where Francesca won't be lit up for a while. You could see how long it took with Charlotte to get her lit up because we had that pickaxe quest, right? So that's kind of the main reason why I would like to move that over. And then of course we have this that I want to use at the beach. And this is uncommon as well, a lamp. I want to use that at the beach too. And then we have you. And you are also, you like lamp and spooky decor, don't like common. So it's going to be really hard to have that here. So we're going to try and see how it works having a birdie down at the beach. But oh, we have so much room, guys. And then we do have these, but I'm going to keep them for right now. Because we might need them right here for the common stuff, right? We're going to get more lamps as we progress. Oh yes. Okay, so so much work, but oh, I kind of like how this turned out. Very nice. Yep. Yeah. Okay, so what do we need to do next? Let's start in one end here. So we're gonna try and have a little talk over here, and of course I just had to, because I haven't done any hoarding yet. That is terrible. I just had to go and pick up a couple of shells. And then I didn't notice while I was doing some stuff, and I was really, really trying to hold off when I was moving around the birdies to not go and pick this up. Because my hoarder tendencies is just terrible. Is there anything else here we can do anything with? There's this. Yep, so let's see if we can harvest you. Mm-hmm. I do absolutely love that these can stack so much higher. Yep. Very nice. Okay, I don't think there's anything else here. Oh, we have to remember because we need to get more of these, right? So I'm gonna have to try and keep an eye out for that. And now things are not moving around anymore, guys. They fixed it. Look at that. My greens ended up here instead of here. And they didn't move everything around like they did before. I absolutely love that because that was driving me nuts. Now I have control over my inventory again, so I can kind of place things where I want them without things kind of getting rotated all the time, because that was such a pain. So I absolutely love that they have changed it. I've seen you going around digging holes, friend. That's a decent shovel you have there. Decent, but I think you can do better. Take a gander at this, the master shovel. Perfect for digging trenches to put piles of stuff in. I'll lend you mine, but I only have 7 of these puppies. What if 6 break? Ooh, yeah, that's terrible. I can see that. Here, get the items from my list and I'll trade that old pro shovel of yours for a master. Phew, okay. So, metal shovel, that's what we have. 25 iron ingots. Wow, look at how many we actually needed for this. And they have, even in this update that we just had, they have actually been balancing out some of, especially his quests, because some of them are very demanding. So, but look at our list that we actually need for this quest. And I happen to have everything because I've kind of been hoarding all of this. That is awesome. So this might actually have required even more before now, because a lot of the requirements have been lowered for him, or for his quests. So there we go. Oh yes, those are some truly cherished and useful memories. Give them over. This pro shovel may not be as strong or tough as the master I'm giving you, but it'll still be great for shoveling my stuff around. I've got to create new piles every week or so, you know, to prevent the old piles of stuff from toppling over. Anyway, enjoy digging up things with your new shovel. I'll be hanging around here with my stuff. Aw, you are just adorable. And we got a new log. Awesome. Okay, so this would then last longer. Oh, 150 durability. Yeah. Very nice. Very, very nice. I like it. Oh, and that means we can harvest this tree over here. Uh-huh. Okay, let's harvest you. That gives us lemons. I think I bought a lemon, didn't I, to hand in? But now we have a lemon at least, so that's nice that we can burn so we can make more jam. Mm-hmm. Give me all the coinsies. Thank you. Oh, yes. Oh, it's so pretty. I really like the decor over here. Look at this with all the little planting areas and pots and things. And it looks like he likes making all kinds of, what do you call that? Like pickled, I guess, like jam, and then you can have pickled vegetables and things. That is cool. Okay, so let's remember to check if we have anything that is getting warm here, right? Okay, so we need a better one for that. Mm-hmm. Let's see. I've come up with a new recipe that you're going to love. I just need a few more ingredients. Ew, okay, so any forageable food, any processed food. We already have these. Not sure what you're going to take from that, but... So I asked in the Discord, and we need another silver ingot. We're going to run out of silver very soon. So I asked in the Discord because I feel like you don't have much control over what they take. And apparently it is supposed to prioritize what you have in your inventory. So I would like to ensure that we don't lose our potatoes, because we don't have that many of them. We have more of the, even though they are rarer. There we go, we just need 3 more, and someone still has a log, that's awesome. But these, where are they? See, we have 24 of these, you only have 7 of these, so I don't really want to lose these. And that means I should be able to, it's easier to do over here so I know where they end up. We just needed 4, right? So I'm going to take these. And by having them in my inventory, that should ensure that that's the one she's gonna take. So she'll look in the inventory before she looks in here, right? And then of course we have these ones. Very nice. What was the rest that you needed? The silver ingot. How many do I actually have left now? Or how much do I have left of all this stuff? We lost our gold ingot. So good thing I hadn't actually donated that yet, because we needed it for this and I haven't gotten any other gold yet. We probably need to upgrade. I don't know if we can get it from the new deposits that we can get with the new pickaxe, or if we have to upgrade it even further before we can get gold. But we still have a little bit of this left, so that's a good thing. Okay, so let's just quickly get that handed in. Yeah. Okay, so thank you so much, Bright Eyes. This will go great in my new sawdust quish. Quiche or something, I think it's called, with tenderized shoe leather drippings. Oh man. Somehow I don't feel very hungry right now. Nope. But you can't say they're not interesting. Oh nice, we got all kinds of foodies. Okay, and I don't know, have we had all of those yet? We might be able to donate some of it. Then we don't even have to craft it ourselves to donate it. Did I get all the coins? I think we did. Lovely, let's have a little look. We had donated this, I think. Potato donut, yes, definitely had. Then we have the corpse salad. Donate to collections for a reward. Okay, we're gonna do that. And the chef salad. Oh, that is so handy. Let's do that. Then we don't have to make them until we actually, unless we actually need them. Which is, I think, one of some of the very few things we have left. Because we have donated. Okay, we need this one, but that's the fruit tinctures that we keep missing from that. And we need a joyous deer essence, so can't really do much about that yet, but we are getting there. This we have donated. Then there's this one. Again, we need the fruit tinctures, but we do have everything else we need. We just need more cocoa beans, but it is Wednesday tomorrow, so hopefully Pandem will have some that we can buy. Because we only get one a day from Mr. Kid, right, that we can buy. And then we have the chocolate galette. That was that one we have donated. Then there's this one. That's gonna take a lot of deluxe screens. Right? Because we need, what is it? 10 for the fancy ones and then 10 of the fancy ones for these. So, wow, that's gonna take a lot. But now we have this one and we have this one, so we don't have to do that. I think we only have, what is that, 3 recipes? Okay, there's also this one, which we could try and work on. We just need to make a lot of roasted root vegetables. Might try and start working on this. And then there's this one, of course, but we can make one of these. So, boiled egg. Oh, we haven't donated one yet. Might do that, but let's craft one. Sounds great. Yep. So we can get more of those. Uh-huh. And then let's make, we are going to need more of these. So let's craft you as well. Get it all sent to us. Thank you. And then we can actually make 2 of these as well. So let's do that. Sounds great. Yeah. Because we have to work on those tinctures. So very nice. Bright Eyes, did you know that you can sometimes find new recipes by fishing? I'd like to say it's a clever marketing campaign for the bakery, but actually my recipe book just got carried off by a strong wind one day. I've been doing a lot of improvising. Okay, we have had that little conversation before. But alright, we should probably do a little bit of fishing when we come back in the next episode. So, thank you for watching, guys. And as always, do take care and happy gaming! Oh, I see another heartbreak here. And they're so close together. Oh, we're gonna have to bring them together and make them happy. So, see you in the next episode.